quite the week for Florida. We had Hurricane Ian join us, which is really funny because even though Hurricane Ian RSVP'd, I don't think any of us thought he was really coming. Spaghetti models? Yeah, how's that for a strategy? So, Weather Service said, hurricane's coming. Friends said, I think the hurricane's coming. Grocery stores said, better stock up on water. We're pretty much out of everything. The hurricane's coming. The hurricanes often don't come. So I'm still going to do my business meetings and I'm gonna go down south. The hurricane dynamic is one of the worst to try to make decisions in because you just have no idea what it's going to do. How many of us have been there when it relates to, I don't know, a lot of things. So, couple of meetings, not gonna cancel. These things never happen.
When life leaves you high and dry, I'll be at your door tonight.
Yes, they do, clearly they do. These types of storms have a huge impact. It is massive. It is powerful. It could go any direction, but it moves really, really slow. And the type A personality in me said, okay, I'm just gonna pack up my bag and I just need to go. It was like 2:30 in the morning.
I was doing all right, but just your side had my heart sewn in.
I was not going to get home anytime soon. The group updates with multiple pictures, the social media updates with multiple pictures, so many of them revolved around trees. And the trees that we were taking pictures of, the broken down ones, the splintered ones, the ones that were just tossed all over the road. Those were a lot of oaks. Those were trees that were absolutely inflexible. They were the trees that had the deepest roots. They were the trees that had been around the longest. They were the trees that had the largest canopy. Those trees were just not able to handle the storm.
No limit.
They broke. And as I thought about the palm trees that I watched, they bent with the wind. The forces against them made them dance.
If I should die this very moment.
Got me thinking about all the storms in life that we all face and how much we want to so often stay strong. Strength isn't how long you've been around or how long you were attached to something or how long you had roots in one place.
Gone, gone, gone.
They didn't plan, none of us did, for what the impact actually would be. Sometimes you can't plan for the impact. Because you have no idea what it's gonna do or be like or feel like. And sometimes, even as much as you plan, you still can't help what falls down around you.
So we're down, we go.
Strength is the choice to be flexible and to move with whatever elements are wrapping around you. You just have to power through. You just have to wait. You just have to be patient. You just have to sit in the moment, the hour, the night, the morning, the day, sit in the storm. We all have a decision on how we can handle situations like this. It's never fortunate, no. Storms never are. Sometimes being flexible is what saves us from all of the elements, but also ourselves. Sometimes there's no way to tell where the damage is or where it's going to be or how bad it's going to be or how much it's going to take to reconstruct. And I think there's a lot of places in life that we can use that as a parallel analogy. Sometimes you just don't know what the rebuild is going to be.
A simple band of gold wrapped around my soul. Heart forgiven, heart forgiven.
And you will have a choice. Hold too strong to what you can't control. Break in the destruction, fall to the ground. So that is what I learned from Hurricane Ian. Bend, flex, and dance. You will find a way through.